friends, welcome back to the channel. Oh boy, are we in for a doozy today. If you're new here, my name's Ash, I'm 27, I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast, and on this channel we play capture the flags while we learn cybersecurity together on our way to becoming a professional. On today's video, we are going over another tryhackme walkthrough. This is for CTF Collection Volume 1. For the notes for this room and all my others, check hack notes down in the description. While you're down there, you can find links that I mentioned in this video and anything else like timestamps. All right, let's go and get started. Okay, so we're on tryhackme like usual. We're at the room, sharpening up your CTF skills with a collection. This first volume is designed for us beginners. So with a quick scroll down that we see a massive 21 tasks. So there's no actual live machine that we can boot up and get access to. So let's see how we can solve this. Starting off at task number one, we can see a note from the author, which reads, just another random CTF room created by me. Well, the main objective of the room is to test your CTF skills. For your information, volume one consists of 20 tasks and all the challenges are extremely easy. We'll see about that. Stay calm and capture the flag. Note, all the challenges flags are formatted as THM, open curly braces flag, close curly braces, unless stated otherwise. High five. All right, let's go on to task number two. Where does the base set? Can you decode the following? And we have a string. So this is most likely base 32 or base 64. So let's go ahead over to CyberChef, one-stop shop, all things coding and decoding. So we can go ahead and paste that in and we already have a magic wand saying from base 64. If we get lost at all, we do have hints and these are pretty much telling us what format or what encoding is being used. So that's gonna be helpful for later when we get a bit stuck. Next up, we have task three, metameta. It says meta, and we have some files to download. So once you've downloaded that, you can drag it over into your VM and we've got findme.jpg. So if we look at the JPEG itself, like there's nothing that we can actually see. There's nothing that we're actually looking for in the picture itself. So the first thing that I like to do is strings, which prints the sequences of printable characters in files. So this is gonna find anything that's hidden in there. Let's just go ahead and run strings against findme.jpg and we can have a quick scroll through. And if we scroll all the way to the top, we can see our flag at the beginning. Cool, so we can submit that. And our hint actually shows us another way of doing it. We can run the XF tool against findme and in there, they've selected the owner name as the flag. That's another way of getting it. Next up for task four, we've got mun. Are we going to be okay? Something's hiding, that's all we know. Let's go ahead and download our task files and that's gonna get us this extinction.jpg. So we can see here that it's just a little cartoon, but again, there's actually nothing that we can see by just looking at a JPEG. So for this one, we're gonna go ahead and use steghide. So this is a steganography program and it's able to hide data in various kinds of images and audio files. And it's also able to read hidden data in said files. So if we keep looking at our man page, we'll eventually find that we wanna use the --- extract flag. And to specify exactly what file, we need to go past the SF. So if we run that against our extinction, it's gonna ask for a phrase. So since we don't actually have one, we can just hit enter. And there we have a final message. So if we go ahead and cat that out, we can indeed see our flag. So we'll paste that in. And out of interest, that was our hint pointing us towards steghide the program. Awesome, let's go ahead on to task five. Magic, where is the flag? Whoa. So if we just go ahead and highlight our description, we'll end up actually seeing the flag. So that was kind of lucky. So the other thing we can do is look at the view source and we can see that what they've done is they've put another span in here. So they've just written the HTML manually and they've just gone ahead and put a background color for this as white. So it's just missing. So if we actually just change that over to all zeros, which is just black, we can then see it a little bit easier. So that's a nice little tricky one there that we can just paste in. So out of curiosity, the hint tells us how to solve that too. Great, so here we have task six for QR. Such technology is quite reliable. So the QR is like QR codes. So there's sort of a little hint of what we're looking for. So we can go ahead and download that. And that's gonna give us a QR.png. So after a little bit of searching, I came across this blogspot page and I tried a few and I found this zbar img command is the one that we're gonna be using. So you can go ahead and install that with the zbar tools. Once you've installed it through apt, you can go ahead and run it against our QR. That's gonna actually read it and we can see here, there is the flag. We can paste that in. Next up, we've got task seven, reverse it or read it. Both works, it's all up to you. So we'll download that and we're left with a hello file. So it looks like that it's some sort of ELF 64-bit high executable. So my go-to with something that I have no idea what to do with is I just go ahead and run strings against it. So after we run strings, we can actually see it in there. Out of interest, since it is an executable, can we just go ahead and run it? And if we just go ahead and change the permissions to allow it to have some executable permissions, and then we go ahead and run it, all we still have is hello there, wish wish you have a nice day. So that's what we did see in strings. It looks like it is just printing out this message here. This is supposed to be printed too, is my guess, but there's some way that we get it there. But hey, we've got it through strings anyway. So we'll go ahead and paste that in. So next up, we have task 8, another decoding stuff. Can you decode it? All right, so we'll highlight that. We'll head back to CyberChef. So we'll paste it in, and we luckily have a suggestion from CyberChef, which is showing base 58. So that one is a nice win for us. We can just go ahead and paste that in. And if we were really stuck, we could use the hint. Next up, we have task 9, left or right. So left, right, ROT 13 for rotate 13 is too mainstream. Solve this. So that's hinting towards the cipher rotating 13. So if we paste it in, so we don't have a suggestion, but we already do have a bit of a hint. So we can go ahead and put in rotate 13. It's not actually giving us anything. So let's just manually change this. So we can sort of go up and down. We'll just start by going down and we'll see if we actually, there we go. We have a tryhackme. So it was at the rotate 7. So if we look at our hint, it's not exactly telling us, but we do know that it's a Caesar cipher. So that's cool. Task 10, make a comment. No downloadable file, no cipher or encoded text. Huh. So we did already have a similar one. We can go ahead and look at the view source. So if we go click here, we can see here that they've done something similar like the last one. They put a P tag in here for paragraph, but they've just gone ahead and put the display none. So we go ahead and just remove that if we wanted to, and we can get the flag that way. Of course, we can just copy it out of the HTML itself. And our hint there is, yeah, just saying to check the HTML. So that's nice and easy for us. All right, over to task 11. Can you fix it? I accidentally messed up with this PNG file. Can you help me fix it? Thanks. So it's going to download a spoil.png. And if we go and try and actually open this file, we get an error. Some files could not be opened. See the text logs for details. So this one was actually quite tricky. We ended up, we have to use the XXD, a program that we're going to use to make a hex dump or do the reverse. So we're going to put a hex dump of this spoil.png, and we'll just go new spoil.png as the output. So if we look at the hex dump of this, it looks like a bunch of nonsense. And this is what was actually really hard about this one. So I don't know how easy this particular task was. So it turns out that we actually need to change the file header. So we've just exported the hex values and it should match up to these hex values at the beginning. I think they call this like the magic number or something. This is what tells like the file system anything that's actually opening a PNG file that it is indeed a PNG file. So we need to go ahead and replace the exact amount of hex value with these 1, 2, 3, 4 values. So we can go ahead and copy them. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So from 2, 3, 5, 4 is what we're going to replace. Backspace that up to F. Then we're putting in 8950 4E47. So that is going to fix up this PNG file. So we can go ahead and save that off as new spoil. And I probably imagine that there's another way to do this, but the way that I know is going back to CyberChef, and we can actually go open file as input. So if we select that new spoil.png, go ahead and we can see the output. So by default, it's just showing us the hex that we've already changed. But if we actually look up from hex, we paste that in. Now we have a render image. So we can go ahead and select that, and that's gonna successfully render the image from our. All right, after we manually type that out, we can hit check and we've got that. So we can move on to task 12, read it. All we have is subhint flag inside tryhackme social account. Now this was another super tricky one. I definitely had to use the hint from here so we can see that we have Reddit. So at least we know what profile we're looking at. So if we search tryhackme and we spell it right, there is a community. If you're not a avid Redditor like me, probably don't go to tryhackme's subreddit all that much. But so then it's a case of just searching through here. So we're not sure if it's somewhere hidden in the wiki. Looks like that things haven't been updated for a while. So it might be a post. So we can indeed search through here, but there's probably a better way of doing this, and we can do it a little bit of Google dorking. So using a couple of commands, we just specify the site that we want to look at, and we can use the in text to try and find something that matches the flag. So remember that we do know what flag format we're after, THM, and then we have curly braces. And we go a step further and look at the title, which will probably have something like try tryhack. So let's go ahead and search that up and let's try and look at our first result here. And we can see here that this was posted 3 years ago. Definitely the room that we're after, and we can see our flag there. So let's go ahead and paste that in, and we can see that that's the right one. So awesome. And please don't be mistaken, but that actually took ages to find. So there were other subreddits that were also looking for this that actually ended up helping me. So yeah, that was a pretty tricky one. Next up, we've got task 13, spin my head. So what is this? Now, if you've done some other rooms, this is going to look familiar. So CyberChef actually doesn't have anything to find this. So what we can do is actually paste it into a file. We'll paste it in like so. We'll save that off, and we can go ahead and use something called beef, which is an interpreter for the binary, which will actually read this file. So we can just run it through beef, and that'll interpret and decode it, and we get our flag. So after task 13, we put task 14, inclusive strings for everyone. So this is another one that tripped me out. I hadn't actually seen this cipher before, so I had to use the hint. So we've got S1XORS2. So I ended up finding another site called Zor Calculator. So this takes in our strings. We can go ahead and get calculate, but that's not going to work because we do need to specify. We can leave both of these hexadecimal, and then we actually get our flag. Paste that in, and let's move on to task 15. We've got binary war. Please exfiltrate my file. This is going to give us a hell.jpg file. So to actually solve this one, we've got binwalk, tool for searching binary images for embedded files and executable code. So let's run binwalk against our file. So as we can see here, we have something zipped inside this file called hello_there.txt. So we can actually just run unzip against our JPEG file, and then we can see that we have unzipped and found this hello there, which we can go ahead and cat that out. So next up, we have task 16, which is called darkness, and we have there is something lurking in the dark. That's going to give us this dark.png. So we can actually use another program similar to steghide, but called stegsolve. And after a little searching, we do need to wget it from a repository. Once we have downloaded it, we can go ahead and run it with Java, and we can go ahead and run that. But if we go and find our dark.png and we start going through the different alpha planes and all these different sort of things that I don't quite understand, right at the end on blue plane, we can see there is our flag. So I don't know how to copy out the text automatically, so I just have to type it in manually, which is painful, but hey, that's fine. Awesome. So let's move on to task 17, and we have a sounding QR. So we've got how good is your listening skill? The flag format is as normal, but this time we have a listened flag. The flag should be in all caps. Doing something a little bit differently this time. So we've got a qrctf.png. And since that this is a QR code like the last one, we can go ahead and just run that through zbar image, and we get a SoundCloud. So we can go over to our SoundCloud link and we can play the flag. And just remember, when you play a SoundCloud song, it'll automatically play whatever else they want to, and it can be really loud. So just be careful of that. So what we can do is go to like a SoundCloud downloader, and we can paste in the URL and we can get it that way. And if we open in like VLC, for example, we can go to the playback speed and make it a lot slower. And after listening to it many, many times, we've got the flag all in capitals. All right, next up we have task 18, dig up the past. Sometimes we need a machine to dig the past up. Target website, we have https://www.embeddedhacker.com, and we have a date. So if the machine wasn't a clue enough and you haven't heard of it, it's called the Wayback Machine. It's a project from the Internet Archive that is trying to capture and store the history of the internet. It's kind of a crazy project, really. So what we can do is paste in the URL that we want to go and look at. And we have a date, the 2nd of January, 2020. So we can click on 2020 and we can see here the 2nd of January and we have one time. And what that's going to do is actually render the HTML and CSS that they have stored. And if we scroll down to this THM flag, we can indeed see there it is. Yeah, that's really cool. Some CTFs use that for like other sites and things. That's a pretty good one to know. Next up, we've got task 19. Can you solve the following? By the way, I lost my key. Sorry. So we have different formats. So this is in tryhackme, not just THM, but we go ahead and try and figure this out. So after a little Googling, we can find out that this is a type of cipher. The Vigenère cipher. It's a method of creating alphabetical text by using a series of interwoven Caesar ciphers based on the letters of a keyword. And that's what's sort of really hard about this is, as we said here, I've lost my key. So we're looking for some key. But what's cool about this site is if we just go automatic decrypt, it's going to just try and find it using different keys and actually found it. So I'm not sure how it works. If it just uses letters out of like what we're trying to decode, but the actual key itself is there. So that's kind of cool. Next up for task 20, we've got decode the following text. So we can go ahead and copy that. So we can paste this into CyberChef. We don't have a suggestion, but looking at our encoded data, all we see is numbers. So it's a good idea that it's probably from decimal, but unfortunately that doesn't want to work. So after giving up on CyberChef, I found the decimal to hexadecimal converter. So we can paste that in from a decimal to hexadecimal, which is going to go ahead and give us a hex number or binary number if you prefer. And we can paste that and put that into CyberChef, and we can just have it automatically go from hex and we get our flag. Ooh, awesome. So last up, we've got task 21, the last task, and we've got, I just hacked my neighbor's Wi-Fi and try to capture some packet. It must be up to no good. Help me find it. So this is going to give us a flag.pcapng. So if you've ever used a pcap file for packet capture file, we can indeed use Wireshark to go ahead and look at this thing. So Wireshark can be a pretty overwhelming program at first. Personally, I still find it fairly overwhelming, but this is going to look at all of the packets for a specific time. And we have a lot here, like a few thousands worth. So instead of running through this all manually, we can go ahead and use the filter up the top here. So there's probably a few ways of doing this, but what I've got is http.request.method is equal to get. Let's go ahead and select enter. That's going to leave us with a single packet, which is much nicer. And we can see that it was getting this flag.txt. So we can see a rundown of flag.txt here. Unfortunately, we can't actually see the output, the contents of this flag. And if we look back at our hint, it says put it into a stream, it'll be much easier. So we need to figure out this stream. So if we right click, we can see follow TCP. So we see some information at the TCP level, but that's not going to actually help us. What we should go is follow the HTTP, and there we can actually see the outputs of flag.txt, and we can get the flag and we can paste that in, and there we go. Wow, awesome. All right, that was a pretty big room. So glad that we got through that. I hope that you enjoyed this video. So thank you so much for watching all the way through to the end. Please feel free to do all the YouTube-y stuff, like, comment, subscribe, ding the bell if you're into it. Up on the screen, I'm going to have a recommended video for you, which is going to go over another great tryhackme room, DAV-DAV. That's going to look at an Apache exploit that you can use for a plugin called WebDAV. That was a pretty good boot to root room, so go ahead and check that out. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.